Brought to you by 1AAuto.com, your source for quality replacement parts and the best service on the internet.
Hi, I'm Mike Green. I'm one of the owners of 1AAuto. I want to help you save time and money repairing and maintaining your vehicle. I'm going to use my 20 plus years experience restoring and repairing cars and trucks like this to show you the correct way to install parts from 1AAuto.com. The right parts installed correctly. That's going to save you time and money. Thank you, and enjoy the video.
In this video, we're going to show you how to replace the blower motor resistor on this Chevy Venture. Now, this is a 99, pretty much the same as any 98 to 05 Venture Montana Silhouette. The only tools you'll need are a 7/32 inch socket with a ratchet and extension, and you'll also need a little flexible joint.
You want to start on the passenger side, underneath, and you want to pull out three pins here, here, and here. And try and grab as close to the pins as you can. And then push down. Okay. Sometimes the pin won't come, so you just use a pair of pliers. And remove it. Okay, and you just kind of let this hang down. If you like, you can take your wire and just kind of, this just goes through and pushes up in. And you just push it down and bring it through.
Okay, so down underneath, first you're going to remove your blower motor, which is that big silver round thing there, and you can see two of the screws, they're the gold screws, and then there's a third one basically directly behind where it's protruding down. And before you unbolt the motor, what you want to do is reach around with your finger, and you'll feel a little tab that you want to push in, and then you kind of pull down on the wires of the lead. It's a little hard to, very hard to film, but you can see there's the connector right there.
Okay, so I'm going to remove the three bolts that hold the motor. Probably easiest to get to the back one with a socket and ratchet. And then the front two, easy enough with just a socket driver. And they are 7/32s. The size of the head is 7/32s, it's a standard size. Those three bolts loosened. The motor basically wants to drop right out. There's a tube on the back here that you want to pull off. Right down.
So now what we're looking at is the resistor with the purple and the black wire going into it, and just above that purple wire you can see that's the bolt you want to remove, and I'm going to loosen up this back one first. Okay, in order to get the third screw you're going to want to unhook this, I think it's an 8 wire lead there, and you can see that there's just a little locking tab there, and you grab it with either your finger or a screwdriver, pull it back, and then pull the harness down and out. Okay, to get up to the other bolt in behind, you can see I have a driver with a flexible joint and then the socket. And I'll put that up in there and loosen up that one.
So now with this screw removed and the two back ones loosened, pull it down and out.
Quick illustration out of the car, remove that bolt, which you can see easily, loosen that bolt, which you can see also, and then loosen that bolt, and then it comes down and kind of slides out and down.
Here's our original, new one from 1AAuto. The 1AAuto one's going to bolt in and plug in. The plugs are the same. It's going to plug in all the same. It obviously looks a little different, but you'll never see that. I am going to reinstall the original one because on this vehicle it's working fine. I just wanted to show you that the new part from 1AAuto will plug in and will fix your issue if you're missing some speeds on your fan.
Okay, and then to put it back in, and this isn't going to be the best video because it's kind of hard to see everything I'm doing here, but you put it up in and then get it to slide back onto those two rear screws. And you want to have those loose enough that you don't really have to try real hard to get it to slide up in there. Then once you get on those screws, it kind of has some tabs that locate it. And then I'm going to wrestle here a little bit. And you want to hold on to it. I think what I end up doing is holding on to it with my right hand, and then using my left hand to get that third screw that's easy to get to, and started in there. And I've been doing this a while, so my fingers are kind of used to making little motions like that and getting those things started. Okay, so I got them all started, and now I can tighten them up.
And then with the everything bolted in, push your connector up in. And reconnect it, and now we can reinstall the blower motor. Before we put this up in here, we're going to take this lead and just kind of stick it underneath that wire so it doesn't get in the way. Okay. And then put it up in, push it. Okay. Start, put this bolt up through. Start it in. Put this bolt up through. Start it. Okay. Reach all the way back here. One.
And now we'll do some fast forwarding through just tightening up those bolts, and you want to get them in there nice and snug. They don't have to be extremely tight because you can strip out the plastic pretty easily. So just get them nice and snug. Keep the speed as we reconnect our vent tube there and then hook up our lead.
Take this and kind of put that up in there. Okay, our courtesy light. Put it down through and push it up and through. Okay, and this just kind of pushes up in there. On somewhere. This just pushes up in like that. Pin up and in, and then our third pin over here.
We hope this helps you out. Brought to you by www.1aauto.com, your source for quality replacement parts and the best service on the internet. Please feel free to call us toll free 888-844-3393. We're the company that's here for you on the internet and in person.